वंस अगेन सिंप्लीफाइंग इट फॉर यू पीपल, बट वंस अगेन आई विल अगेन रिपीट व्हाट आई टोल्ड अर्लियर इज दैट दिस दशा इज मेंशन्ड नोवेयर, ओके, एंड वी गेट इट फ्रॉम परंपरा. दिस वॉज सीक्रेटली पर्सनली टॉट टू मी एंड इट इज नो बुक नो क्लासिक नो अंडरस्टैंडिंग नथिंग. I have made it simple. This is for nakshatra activation. Okay, and as I have already told you, that time works in a cycle. So there is no occasional sprouting of, you know, this thing will happen at this point of time or that point of time. It is not like that. Everything works in a cycle. So here is the table that I have just taught you, remastered. And I will teach you the same thing again with simply, in a simplistic way. So this is the order of nakshatras and this is the years that they rule. What you have to do is you have to find your birth nakshatra. Okay. Now suppose someone is born in Adra. So for the first year, Adra will be ruling. For the next 4 years, Punarvashu. Next, the next 3 years, Pushya. Next 6 years, Asalesha. Next 5 years, Magha. Next 2 years, Purva Falguni. Next 4 years, Dhanishta. Next 1 year, Satavisha. Not 100 years. 1 year, Satavisha. 2 years, Purvabhadra. 2 years, Uttarabhadra. Next 32 years, Revati. And so on and so forth is when these nakshatras are activated. Right? A total of these years is 122. Right? So this dasha works for 122 years. 120 is the maximum longevity of a human, as Parashara says. Right? Though no one lives up to 122 by the way. So what you have to do is you have to first find which dasha is activated for a person, right, at this particular point of time. So you find that, okay. Let we do a calculation. Whose horoscope I should take and do a calculation. If I have your details, just give me 2 events of your life, probably the age when that happened. When the event happened.
Job, sir.
Ha, ma'am, job. So you tell me the job date by the time I will make your horoscope.
1984 itself.
1984, you got a job. So 1984, you get a job. Okay. Fine. And you are born in 66. So it becomes as 1984 minus 66. It was at the age of 18. Oh, madam. I see. Balshali Jupiter does this. So though I have told you where to start the dasha from.
Yes, Barney. Mine is Barney.
Okay. So the sun is in Virgo, moon is in Taurus, Lagna is in Barney. So we started from moon. Moon is exalted. So let's start the dasha from Rohini. Let's start the dasha from Rohini in 1966 born. So it starts from Rohini. Okay. Rohini, 1966 plus 5 years to Rohini. So 66 plus 5 up to 1971, it is Rohini. The remaining, then the next 3 years will go to Mrigashira.
74.
Then the next 4 year goes to Anuradha. That is 1978. The next 3 years up to 1981 goes to Jyeshtha. The next 11 years up to 1992 goes to Mula. The next 2 years up to 1994 goes to Purvashada. The next 2 years up to 1996 goes to Uttarashada. The next 3 years up to 1999 goes to Shravan. Plus 1 year up to 2000, Adra. Plus 4 years up to 2004, Punarvasu. Next 3 years up to 2007, Pushya. Next 6 years up to 2013, Asalesha. Next 5 year up to 2018, Magha. 2020, Purva Falguni. 4 years up to 2024 goes to Dhanishta. And 25, Satvisha. 26, 27, 28, 29. And 2029 plus 32 up to 2061 will go to Rayavati. Madam, 2-3 more events if you can just send them in the chat box.
90 marriage, 91 son. You can take 1990 marriage. 91 October son.
91 son. So we have three events. 1984 she gets a job.
And 1995 father's death December.
1995 December father's death. 1996 you also said marriage.
1991 marriage.
1991 marriage.
Sorry, 90 son. Marriage, 91 son.
90 marriage, 91 son. Job idhar, marriage idhar, son bhi idhar. So job, marriage, son, this all goes to the activation of Mula.
Yeah.
And father's death happens in the activation of Uttarashada. Now how this works is we have to go to Sarvatobhadra Chakra. Okay. This Sarvatobhadra Chakra is a very huge technique. Okay. And this is not from normal astrology. This is from the tantric part of astrology. So there is one particular aspect of astrology that the tantrics have been using since ages. So Sarvatobhadra Chakra comes from there. Okay. So let's see how the Mula is activated. What we generally do is we take the horoscope of the person. The simple method. Go to the chakras and open. You will be landing here. You go to Sarvatobhadra Chakra. This order is fixed. Okay. This order for the Sarvatobhadra Chakra is fixed. Right? Seven nakshatras a year. And these different things. So basically what happens is one nakshatra aspect three nakshatras, one in the front. So Purva Bhadra aspects Chitra in the front. One in the backward motion, Purva Bhadra, G, K, H, Uttarashada. Uttarashada in the backward and it aspects one nakshatra in the front, Purva Bhadra, B, A, R, T, A, K, Punarvasu. So it aspects Punarvasu in the front, Uttarashada in behind and Chitra in front. Okay, this is forward motion because Ashwini, Bharani, Kratika, Rohini, Mirgashira, Adra, forward motion. This is the backward motion, Purva Bhadra, Satamsha, Dhanishta, Sarabhan, Abhijit, etc. There is Abhijit Nakshatra is included into it. So if you quickly want to find which planet is placed in Abhijit Nakshatra, you used to open Sarvatobhadra Chakra that gives you a quick view about it. However, so what you do is you right click over it and you write highlight Vedas, aspects and Luktas on the star, if any. And by right clicking this, you specifically get the planets. Now there is one very particular thing that is highlighting the Veda aspect and Lukta. So this, what you see is Veda. As I told you, na, Purva Bhadra will influence Uttarashada, Punarvasu and Chitra, that is Veda. This Sun and Venus probably is having a Latta on it. That's why they are also Mar. Though they are not in Chitra, Sun is in Hasta, Venus is in Uttara Palguni. But probably they are having a Latta on Purva Bhadra. Let's see. Latta on Purva Bhadra. Aspect. Yeah. So Venus is having an aspect on Purva Bhadra and Sun is also having an aspect on Purva Bhadra. Now, how Jagannath Thura is calculating the aspect of the planet over Nakshatras, I don't know. Maybe they have coded something. I haven't experimented with it. Okay. Now, why she is getting married in why she is getting married, and also you know, she, with the activation of Moola, she gets a job, she gets married, and she also gets a son. Three things happen with the activation of Moola. You go to her Sarvatobhadra Chakra, and Moola will aspect Punarvasu. Moola will aspect Uttarabhadra, and Moola will aspect Chitra, where Mercury is situated, highlight Veda aspect and Lattas, and we find influence over Punarvasu, Revati, and Chitra, and there is Mercury there also. Right? So the results told by Mercury will be felt in the dasha of Moola Nakshatra, or when the Moola Nakshatra is activated, the result of Mercury will be felt. Now the result, yes, ma'am.
Mercury is in 7th house also.
Okay. Ascendant is here, madam, in front of it. Okay. So we have to see the nakshatra of Mercury, the house where Mercury is situated, the house is lorded by Mercury, all, and that will be signifying all the things that is happening there. We go to the horoscope, we find Mercury situated in the 7th house, marriage clear. She is getting a job also. Why she is getting a job? Because Mercury is the lord of the 6th house. And she is having a child also. Because 6th house, there is the 5th lord, whose dispositor Mercury. 5th lord sun in the 6th house, dispositor Mercury situated in the 7th house, also the lord of the 6th house. So job, marriage, children. Is it clear?
All activated.
All activated.
Ketu was also activated like anything. Now I can understand. Urakil, yes. 7th house. Just after marriage.
Yes. Yes. And the father's death happens with the activation of Uttarashada. Uttarashada Nakshatra activates Saturn and Venus. First of all, Saturn being the enemy of Sun, is himself is a karaka for father's death. And if you just see the horoscope, Saturn is having his 10th malefic influence on the 9th house. And Venus, who is debilitated, is afflicting the significator of father's son. Right? Or wrong? And you see the 9th Lord Jupiter is in this one. Virgo Navamsha, that is further the debilitation of Venus. Right? So the activation of Venus and Saturn, because Uttarashada have a Vedha on Uttara Falguni and Purva Bhadra. Purva Bhadra, Saturn is situated, Uttara Falguni, Venus is situated. And this is happening. First of all, Saturn himself is the enemy of Sun. So Sun is the Garga for father. Saturn creates problem to father also. There is the 10th aspect of Saturn over the 9th house, giving problems to father, and Venus, debilitated Venus is afflicting Sun. Right? Venus is weaker as compared to Sun. Venus is debilitated. He is afflicting the Sun. Sun is the significator of father. Saturn is also afflicting the Sun with the 7th aspect, by the way. All right. So the event of father's death is very clear or not. See, one thing I will tell you with this Sarvatobhadra Chakra, as I told you, this is a very extensive technique. Just one small point. Planet retrograde have their most powerful impact on the previous nakshatra. This is previous, right? Previous. His retrograde, most important influence on the previous nakshatra, direct. More strongest influence on the forward nakshatra. And Sun and Moon have the most strongest influence in the frontal nakshatra. So that's for some other day. I will not explain how this technique works. So you get the simple stuff. You open the Sarvatobhadra Chakra. See the nakshatras falling in front, in behind, in forward motion to the nakshatra which is activated. See the planets there. You go to the horoscope. See which houses the planet are situated, which houses are lorded by the planet, aspected by the planet. That gives you the event. Simple, clear, quick. And in the class, we have also seen the example of Asutosh Biswalji and how he is getting married and how he is getting a job. Through this, right? So use this. And see, this is the simplicity of parampara dashas. You know, when it comes to Vimshottari and other dashas, because I haven't made them, I cannot tell you, you know, I am not very sure about it. This dasha was taught in tradition to me. It was not into this format. It was in some other format. I researched over it and I changed it. And you know, such a research, when you are going to invent a brand new dasha, you're getting my point. If I give you a classic and will tell you research some rules out of it, it will take you much time, much mental stuff, right? So researching a brand new dasha from the starting, you know how difficult the task it is. And now because I myself have developed it, I can vouch for that it will work. Because see, it is not a one day task. It is not a 1 year task. It takes you decades. Building something from scratch.
One another technique which is very much applicable in my chat, I'll tell you. I heard somewhere that Sun is father and my fifth lord, which is Sun being Aries, it is in the sixth house. So my father was in government job and I got government job in the 18th year. As soon as I joined the government job, my father's problems started like anything. So somewhere it is there that two government job people in such a type of horoscope cannot stay in a home, or there will be difficulty starting.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Is it
correct? No.
Can say. Though, ma'am, I strongly believe in that people have individual fate. So that thing is there. No. But by this dasha, so. Telling you it. See, what I was told is, okay, you know what, nakshatras also have a dasha is what I was told. Only this much. Ki there is a nakshatra dasha and nakshatras also get activity. I'm like, okay, fine, then what? And this was told to me very early. Later on, one day I was sitting, I was like, oh, there is no dasha based on nakshatra. Whenever we say nakshatra dasha, we land to Vimshottari. So this is Kritika Dasha, sun ruler Kritika Dasha. What is this? This is a Nakshatra Dasha or what, planet Dasha? So basically it is a planet Dasha. Nakshatra is not worth. So my thing was, let's find a Nakshatra Dasha. Then the stars of the Nakshatras have some correlation, and I have taught you 2-3 techniques of how to use the stars to time marriage in the Prashna, etc. also. So that was the traditional uses which is taught. But I'm like, if it can be used in a Prashna, there can be a particular method using which it can be used in the natal chart also. Right? So this particular experiment. And because this is my own invention, I vouch for the applicability of the technique. So today after this class, you forget everything. Use this calculation is, I think, pretty simple. You can use just a simple calculator to do it. No dasha sishta, dasha pinda, dasha bhukta, dasha bhogya not needed. You just calculate it, do it, and Sarvatobhadra Chakra you will get in any software, just the Vedas and Lattas over it, and that is pretty clear. Okay, good. Acha, listen. Thoda sa maja karte hain. So, ma'am, aapka jo main chart dekhta hoon, isme your home, your house is north facing or south facing? My mic is moved.
My own purchased house was, yeah, north facing. First house north facing, second house east facing, both sold.
Both sold. Now in the home where you are living?
I was always in quarter, never in rented house, government quarter.
Government quarter is which direction facing?
Government, it is flat, sir.
Entry of the flat.
Entry east-west.
West facing. ऐसा आपके रूम का नहीं, वो पूरे टावर का एंट्री,
पूरा टावर.
और आपके रूम का एंट्री?
मेरे रूम का
एंट्री मतलब भी आपके फ्लैट का एंट्री.
एक मिनट, ईस्ट साउथ, साउथ है शायद.
साउथ साउथ
मैं भी साउथ में हूँ, घर भी साउथ में.
देखो सर, आई विल टेल यू स्टफ. प्लैनेट्स कनेक्टेड टू द नवांश लग्न. ओके, दिस इज द स्टफ. Planet connected to the Navamsh Lagna have a connection with your home. All the planets connected, all of them. Okay. So see the Navamsh Lagna. Mercury is in the ascendant. Mercury indicates north direction. Mars aspects the ascendant. Mars indicates the south direction. Two aspects are there. Third aspect is not there. So either north facing because of Mercury or south facing because of Mars. Point one. Another thing is Mercury will indicate green color. Mars will indicate red color. So there have to be a prominence of green and red color.
Yes.
Mars will indicate number 9, Mercury will indicate number 5. So the total of the home address should be either 5 or 9.
3025.
So this is what works. And so this I also use for the rectification of the, you know, rectification of the Navamsha. Just ask the house number and this will be doing the case for you. And so this Navamsh, planets connected to the Navamsh Lagna basically decides the which color is prominently used in your home, your home number, facing direction it is facing.
Full of green.
Ma'am, third floor pe to nahi rehti hain?
Third floor pe rehti hu. 302 hai na?
Third. See why I am saying third floor, because Mercury is in the Lagna and that is the lord of the third house from the ascendant. So third floor.
Mercury will creep in, because I am sitting in your Navamsha Lagna.
Make some place for me. And so this Navamsha Lagna is always having a connection. That is point one. And if there is a good planet in Navamsha that you see and you want it to get activated, like Sotapaji is having an exalted Venus in the fifth house. In Pisces, she is having an exalted Venus in the fifth house. Now Venus indicates water, Venus indicates decorations, etc. And fifth house indicates study areas and study things. So she should make a study room. Should paint it white, the color of Venus, should have a fountain there, should have some water body there, should have some decorative items there for the activation of Venus. And once that is done, Venus will be activated and this Venus will give good money because he's the lord of the second house in the D1 chart. House lordship I always take from D1 chart, right? Never the house lordship from the divisional charts, no. Always from the D1 chart, right? Whenever she will purchase a decorative item, she will have to go at some place, either for traveling or for work purpose or anything, she will have to go. Whenever she purchases a very good decorative item or something, because Venus is also the lord of the seventh house, which indicates travel. Then the decorative item will also be, you know, good for money because that is the lord of the second house as well. Right?
Yes, correct.
This particular thing, one more stuff I have to tell. The planet in the Kendra of D1 chart. Strong planet. Okay. The planet in the Kendra of D1 chart, strong planet. In her chart, she have a Jupiter strong and a Mercury strong. Mercury strong because Mercury is an exchange with Venus. So strong planet, exchange planet, strong planet. Now see the sign where the planet is aspecting. The most powerful aspect of the planet is in which Rashi? Okay. And you remember Lagna is east, 10th house is south, 7th house is west, and the 4th house is north. So if the Lagna is east and 10th house is south, 11th house and 12th house is southeast. So Jupiter is exalted in the 4th house and Jupiter's most powerful influence will be on the 12th house over his own Rashi. That indicates the southeast direction, right? So the place where she is born, southeast to that, there should be a Devi temple or should be a Vishnu temple or a Shiva temple. Rather, this Jupiter should indicate Shiva or a Devi temple, not a Vishnu temple. Vishnu temple will be indicated by this Mercury. Mercury aspects Lagna. So east side, Vishnu temple, and southeast side, a Devi temple or a Shiva temple should be there at the place where she is born. And there should also be a river, pond, lake, or a water body in north, because Jupiter north exalted at the birthplace where the person is born. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir. सर यू आर लाइक अ मैजिशियन सर, ऐसा 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 इतने जल्दी 2 मिनट में पूरा बोल दिया सर, हम कब पहुंचेंगे वो लेवल पे.
You see, I have also told the technique.
Yeah.
इस वीडियो को स्लो करके चलाने का. So I have also told the technique. See, it, madam, it never happens. See, people have this bad habit. You know, they will tell you this must have happened. Why they will not tell? I never do this. Whenever I say something, I always give a reason. This reason. And see, usme bhi I haven't told you because Jupiter is in the fourth house. This will be there. I specifically told कि जहां पर ग्रह बैठा है, जहां एस्पेक्ट करता है, वह एस्पेक्ट की राशि के डायरेक्शन. अब एनोनिमसली नहीं कह रहा हूं मैं यहां फोर्थ में जुपिटर है तो ये होगा, फिर आप फोर्थ जुपिटर लेके लगाते रहोगे जिंदगी और कभी नहीं काम करेगा. नो, आई ऑलवेज हैव दिस थिंग, आई विल गिव यू अ टेक्निक, क्लियर स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड, कि भाई दिस इज द टेक्निक एंड दिस यू अप्लाई इन एनी हॉरोस्कोप. इफ इट इज अ कंडीशनल टेक्निक, आई विल टेल यू दैट इट इज अ कंडीशनल. भाई व्हाट टाइप ऑफ गुरु आई एम इफ आई कीप यू इन अ डार्कनेस? आपको अंधेरे में रखने से आई एम नॉट अ गुड गुरु, दैट इज वेरी सर्टन. Just one small vastu technique, just a small one. Two vastu technique, the small one. Okay. So basically 1, 5, 9 indicates east. So this house direction, so you remember now. Right? Lagna is east and the 10th house is south, and these two houses are southeast. But for this particular method, 1, 5, 9 house is east. 2, 6, 10 south. 3, 7, 11 west. And 4, 8, 12 north. Clear? Now, dekho, what you have to do is, sun is the karaka for temple, moon is the karaka for water body, Mars is the karaka for kitchen and where you keep your firearms, etc., hathiyar, weapons. Mercury is the karaka for playground, children's room. Jupiter is karaka for treasury, where you keep your cash, not temple, temple sun. Venus is the karaka for bedroom where people copulate, and Saturn is the karaka for dustbin, storage room, garbage room, etc. See, what you have to do is, I will tell you simple method. Take the Ashtaka Varga of the planet. For an example, I have to see where should Sutapa ji keep his temple. So for that, I will take the Ashtaka Varga of sun. Add the points. 1, 5, 9 houses, 3, 3, 6 plus 4, 10 points in total. East direction, 10 points. ठीक है, 3 plus 3 plus 4, 3, 3, 6 plus 4, 10. In the south direction, 3 plus 2 plus 5. South direction, 3 plus 2 plus 5, 10. In the west direction, 3, 7, 11 houses, 5 plus 3 plus 5, 13. Okay, so this west is ruling right now. And in the 4, 8, 12 houses, we see 4 point, 3 point, 8 point, 50. So this north is now ruling. So out of all the four trines, north is the most powerful one. Right? So she should keep her temple in north. So temple will be south facing, but when she will worship, she will be north facing. And north is the direction of Kuber. By the way, north is ruled by Mercury and she have Mercury in Navam Shagana once again. So there is an interconnection between it. Okay, another example for bedroom. Bedroom we will see from Venus, as I just told you. Okay, so Lagna, 5th house, 9th house, 6, 6, 12, 4, 16. Yeah, 16. So 1, 5, 9, 16. 2, 6, 10, 11 points in total. 3, 7, 11, 10 points in total. 4, 8, 12, 11 points in total. So basically, नहीं 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 गड़बड़ कर दिया यार. 6 plus 6 plus 4, 1, 5, 9 is having 16 points. 5 plus 2 plus 4, 11 points in the south direction. 6 plus 3 plus 3, 12 points in the west direction, and 6 plus 4 plus 3, 13 points in the north direction. So basically the points in the east direction, 6 plus 6 plus 4, in 1, 5, 9 houses rules, right? So she should have her bedroom in the east direction of the home. Bedroom, the room in the east. Okay, so once again, Venus for bedroom, Saturn for garbage storage, etc. Jupiter for treasury, cash, gullak. Mercury for playground, children's room, study room. Mars for kitchen and where you keep your weapons. Moon for water bodies, bathroom, etc. Water storage, bathroom, etc. And sun is for temple. And ascendant decides which direction is good for you to live. You know, which direction of the city, which direction of the country, which direction of the state, which direction of the world, which direction of the universe. If you can shift it to Mars, please do. Though we cannot, right?
Sir, I had a doubt.
Yes, ma'am.
In my house, my southwest is cut. So that does not have to do anything with the Vastu or anything. Matlab, if I have to go with the chat.
If one direction is cut, is a problem in Vastu, basically. So you said southeast is cut.
Southwest.
Southwest is cut. So southwest is basically Rahu. So you should have a bad condition of Rahu in the horoscope. And by shifting to that property, the bad results of Rahu are fit.
So over here, my chart has to be analyzed or my husband's chart has to be?
Actually, because you also live, so it have an impact on you, it have an impact on your husband, it have an impact on your children also. Now, because you have Rahu in the seventh house situated with Sun, the Lord of the fifth house, there have to be problems related to children, promotion, gain of power and marriage after shifting to this home. These problems have to be there because you have Rahu in the seventh house. So when you shift to such a property, these problems you have, and there is a certain type of problem that your husband will be facing, a certain type of problem that your children will be facing, all dependent on the situation of the Rahu in the horoscopes.
Okay.
Yeah. So basically how it works is I have Saturn in the ascendant, Saturn rules the west direction. So I always look for a west facing property. Lavanesh activated na, keeps you in good health. Good health we want.
So now if I have to complement it, so what is the remedy I have to do?
Ma'am, dekhi, abhi Rahu is there in the seventh house. Seventh house will be the west direction. And Rahu indicates the air element. So air element is some incense stick, etc. You light and keep in your west direction. Some incense stick related to Rahu. Rahu also indicates statues, etc. made up of some animal. So, you know, like elephant ke daant ka kuch bana hota hai, chamde ke kuch bana hota hai. So these things are also indicated by Rahu. Rahu will also indicate an idol of Saraswati, etc. So idol of Saraswati or some idol or image made up of some animal body part, tiger skin, etc., etc. Some idol, etc. related to that or incense sticks, etc. in the western direction you should be burning. Because Rahu is in the seventh house indicates west.
West. So, matlab, that's got nothing to do with southwest. Mujhe Rahu ko
southwest to aapka kata hai. Dekho, isko baat aap samjho. House is our personal. House is where we have to do the work.
Yeah.
The natural direction of the planet is the area which is naturally affected.
Okay.
So naturally affected hua to Rahu ka role aaya. Ab wo direction mein to ma'am dosh hai hi. Wahan pe hum kuch karenge to dosh aggravate kar denge.
Haan.
To karenge kahin aur. Theek hai nahi? Aise.
Perfect sir.
Abhi isme ye bhi ho sakta tha ki northwest is cut because of Rahu and Rahu is also situated in the direction which is indicated by northwest. तो वहां पर मैं कहता कि नो यू कैन नॉट डू एनी रेमेडी बिकॉज वहीं पर दोष है वहीं पर उपाय करना है दोष पर उपाय नहीं किया जा सकता बट फॉर्चुनेटली यू हैव राहु इन वेस्ट एंड द प्रॉब्लम इज इन नॉर्थ वेस्ट तो एटलीस्ट वन पार्ट ऑफ इट कैन बी टेकन केयर ऑफ है ना तो रेमेडी वी विल डू हाउस बेस्ड द ऑटोमेटिक रिजल्ट विल बी राशि बेस्ड
ओके परफेक्ट सर माय हस्बैंड्स राहु इज इन द 10th हाउस So again, that's giving a little problem and I'm able to connect, sir. Thank you, sir.
Most welcome, ma'am. Planetary directions, I think we have covered in the last class. Yeah, Sun rules the east, Moon northwest, Mars south, Rahu southwest, Ketu is the upward direction. So upward direction means if you have some things on your, kuch log hote hai na, ghar ke piche piche tanki bana lete hai. केतु हरिओम हो जाता है उनके जीवन का केतु इज द ब्रह्म स्थान ऑफ द होम यू नो ब्रह्म स्थान ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी